Hello guys, welcome back. Today I'll show you how to connect two Linux machines without using your password. Okay, so today I'll show you how to connect from one machine to another machine, another remote machine, using key-based authentication. Okay, normally there are two types of authentication, right? One is password-based authentication and the other one is key-based authentication. So in case of password-based authentication, what you need? You need the user ID and the password of the remote machine to connect from the local Linux machine to the remote machine, right? But in case of key-based authentication, what is required? You need the key of the remote machine or the local machine to set up in the remote machine so that we can, without using the password, we can connect seamlessly from your local machine to remote machine. Okay, so for that, what we need? We need the SSH protocol to be set up between the two machines, right? So normally SSH is a protocol being used in Linux or Unix machines to connect from one machine to another machines. So the default port of SSH is 22. Okay, so when you connect to the machine, so SSH protocol use that 22 port between to these servers should be open, and that using that can connect, right? For that we have to do some setups. So this is normally we are going to see how we'll do the key-based authentication. For that, what we have to do? We have to first create the private and public key of the local machine from where you are going to connect to the remote machine. Okay, so from one side, from local to remote. Okay, for that, what we have to do? We have to generate the key from the local machine, from the machine from where you are going to connect to the remote server, and then that public key of that machine you have to share and save into the authorized key of the remote machine. After that, we can easily connect to the server. Okay, let's start. Okay, I have created two machines on AWS using AWS EC2 services. Okay, two Linux machines created. One machine I'm going to use as my remote machine, and from other machine I'll try to connect that machine using key-based authentication. Okay, so let's start. So I have connected already to one machine. From this machine I'll try to connect to the remote machine. Okay, let me open another tab and I'll try to connect to that machine. Okay, so now what we can do, just see, from this machine if you try to connect to that machine, what will happen? Let's see. So SSH Ubuntu, okay, @ the IP address of the remote machine, the public IP of the remote machine. So just paste it here. And see, from this Linux machine, I'm not able to connect to that remote Linux machine. Means from machine 1 to machine 2, I'm not able to connect because there is no connectivity has been set up yet, right? So let's start to create the public and private key first to generate the key. In Unix or Linux, there is a command called SSH, okay, hyphen key gen. Using this command, we are going to generate the key. So before that, what you have to do? You have to go to the home directory of the user. This is user's home directory, home Ubuntu. In that home directory, just go to cd.ssh. So this .ssh is a hidden folder, hidden directory. Okay, here we have to generate the key. Let's see if there is any key already available. No, there is no keys available. Okay, so what we have to do now? Let's generate the key. Okay, ssh-key, just enter. Here it's asking to provide the file name to save the key. So I'm just keeping it as it is. I'm not going to give anything I'm leaving it empty so that the default file name will be created, that is id underscore rsa. Enter on the phrase name, you can give the passphrase whatever you want, but I'm keeping it as empty. Now let's say the key is generated. See, there are two files generated. One is id underscore rsa, the other one is id underscore rsa dot pov. So this is your private key and this is your public key. Okay, so what we need this public key to be pasted over the authorized key of the remote machine, the authorized key of the other machine. Okay, so for that, what we have to do, let's get the key. So you have to get the key of this, right? Enter. So this is your public key of the machine from where you are going to connect to the remote machine. Okay, just copy this one, go to the remote machine, go to the home directory. Okay, see, you are in home directory. Yes, go to the again .cd.ssh. here if you see, there will be one authorized key files there. So if this authorized key file is not there, you cannot connect or you cannot add the keys. For that, what you have to create this key file first and then paste your keys. Let me open the key file using VI editor. Okay, let's paste it. What I'm going to do, paste, enter. So before that, already one key is there. This key is some other machines. Okay, now what I'm going to do, end of this file, I'm going to paste the key whatever I have copied from the machine from where I'm going to connect. Paste it here. Okay, now save this file. Okay, just do another look. So our key is pasted in the authorized keys of the machine which I'm going to connect from other machine. Okay, so now what you have to do, our public key is pasted under the authorized key. Let's start the same. Now let's start to connect to the machine. Okay, so what you have to do, type SSH username and the IP address of the machine, hit enter. So first time it will ask, are you sure you want to continue to connecting to the machine? That means you are going to add the fingerprint of that machine to the known host file. Just type yes, hit enter. Now the fingerprint is permanently added. Now you can see we are successfully connected to the machine, right? This is the remote machine IP. Now you can see, yeah, nothing is there. This is the home directory of the remote machine. So this is how you can connect from one machine to another machine using key based authentication without password. So this is a very secure way to connect to one machine to another machine. We see connecting one machine to another machine using key based authentication, right? So this is one sided connectivity, means from one machine to another machine you connected, but that machine, from remote machine, how you connect back to this machine, right? So for that, what we have to do, just connect to the remote machine. Okay, so here what you have to do, go to the home directory again .cd.ssh. so here what you have to do, generate the private and public key. Okay, so same, we have to use SSH hyphen key gen. Enter. So I used the default files for the keys. Okay, so if you see it here, so we have public key and private key generated. Okay, now copy this public key. Okay, copy this public key, go to the, so is 40, 200 is the machine which we are going to connect, right? So here, if you see, one authorized key also will be there, right? Just open this authorized key, enter. Here, just add the key of the remote machine, what you copied, okay, public key. Save it. Now we saw from this machine to that machine connectivity, right? From this machine, now we'll see from this machine to that machine, right? Machine B to machine A, suppose. What do you do? Just type SSH. Okay, Ubuntu is the Ubuntu. Now get the public key of that machine, right? So get the public key. Go here, paste it here. Okay, first time to last, yes. Enter. See, now we successfully able to connect to the machine. So now the connectivity is from two side. From machine A to machine B we can connect, and machine B also can connect to the machine A using the password based, sorry, a key based authentication, not password based. Okay, it's password less connectivity. Now what you can do, so we can see both sided connectivity happen. Connect to the remote machine. Now Ubuntu get IP of the remote machine here. Okay, enter. See, now from this 40-200 machine we connect into 2725, and from here also from 2725 to we connected to. So now we saw how to connect from one machine to another machine using key based authentication method. Okay, thank you for watching my tutorial. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have not subscribed my channel, do subscribe it. If you have any questions or any concerns, if you want to learn more, do comment on the comment section below. Thank you.